I thought they were robust. And I think to some extent, when you factor China in, they actually beat expectations, especially when you look at the outlook. I think there's a stock that's up today. And I think it further validates what we obviously been talking a lot, you know, with you and the team about the AI story now playing out into the next stage of growth. This is bullish, in my opinion.
Dan, what was your takeaway here as it relates to a lot of the spending here, CapEx?
I think it just shows there's one chip in the world fueling the AI revolution. It's led by godfather of AI, Jensen Huang. And you look what's happened on CapEx, it's just continuing to accelerate. And then you factor in China, that could be $50 billion. I mean, and Jen's talking about the 50% growth. I think this is just now, it's showing the next phase of the AI revolution is now starting to play out, especially when you combine it with hyperscalers and everything we've seen from Palantir, now Snowflake, MongoDB, the use cases are expanding.
Dan, flesh out for us the whole China situation. Where is NVIDIA today vis-a-vis China? And how do you think this is going to play out over the coming quarters with our H20 chip?
Yeah. Paul, look, they're caught in the middle between U.S. and China. But the reality is Jensen's 10% politician, 90% CEO. And Trump administration knows biggest chip on the poker table is NVIDIA. So as this all plays out, it's a pay-for-play model. They're going to have access to China, even if it's restricted. And that's going to add an increment of, what, $2, $5, $6 billion per quarter? And you know, even though Beijing telling you know maybe these companies, you don't want to buy NVIDIA chips, that's like telling a kid not to eat candy. Big tech in China wants NVIDIA chips.
So, I mean, as we dig in here into the data, what we saw from the earnings report, what is your takeaway in terms of what they were able to see specifically in terms of data center AI demand? That's definitely something that's been in focus here with this report.
Yeah, look, I think it's noise in terms of any quote unquote like miss, because like, when you factor China, it's basically over 1.5 billion feet. They're seeing demand accelerate. I mean, no region is not showing acceleration. And now you're starting to factor in what's going to happen in the Middle East, what's going to happen in China, what's going to happen in the rest of the world. And you're really talking about one chip that's fueling it. So when I look at NVIDIA, I think there's a $5 trillion market cap potentially by year end or early 26. And it's just further validation for the AI revolution thesis.
So talk to us, Dan, about their customer base and the concentration of their customers. And I know they want to broaden out their customer base, maybe to sovereigns and to other net buyers out there. How do you think that's going to evolve?
Well, big tech's going to continue to dominate as a quote-unquote customer base in terms of the concentration. But now as sovereigns play out, as enterprises play out, you're going to see more and more people, you know, obviously start to understand that this revolution is not just big tech. It's about other sort of regions starting to play. And there's only one chip in the world fueling it, and that's NVIDIA.
So taking a step back here, NVIDIA wrapped up all of the Mag 7 earnings here. What were your thoughts more broadly overall this earnings season?
I mean, I think this is the bullish tech earnings season. We've talked about it. The validation of the AI revolution hits next stage of growth. It's spreading second, third, fourth derivatives. Now, granted, look, NVIDIA is the Scottie Scheffler of tech, okay? But what you're starting to see now play out is those derivatives, the spending, the multiplier, it's all happening. And I think that's just bullish going into year end in terms of tech stocks. And I think this bull market has 2 to 3 year run still left.